This is the second lesson of mean variance and standard deviation for our probability distribution. In the first lesson, we have learned how to calculate the mean. In this lesson, we will learn how to calculate the variance and standard deviation for our probability distribution. So we have learned the mean, variance and standard deviation for our samples and population. But in this lesson, we are going how to calculate variance and standard deviation for a probability distribution. So I told you that the range of probability is between 0 to 1. If we add the probabilities of the sample spaces, it should be equal to 1. What does it mean? Suppose in the case of a coin, there is 50% probability that the head will come and there is 50% probability that the tail will come. So half plus half is equal to 1. So we have distributed 1 into 2 parts in the case of a coin. This is the probability distribution. Similarly, in the case of a roll, when we roll a die, there are 6 numbers 1 to 6 and each side has a probability of 1 over 6 plus 1 over 6 plus 1 over 6. So 6 times we have to write down this. Then when we will add all this, here 2 more times. So it will be 6 over 6, which is equal to 1. In the case of a die, we have distributed probability into 6 equal parts, 1 over 6, 1 over 6, 1 over 6. Right? But again, it is not necessary that it should be equal. But if it is different at the end, when you will make the total, it should be equal to 1. So we will learn in this lesson how to calculate the variance and standard deviation for a probability distribution. So the formula we will use in order to calculate the variance and standard deviations is sigma square is equal to, this is called the summation, means total of x square. What is the x square means? X is any variable, you can write down x, y, z, whatever. In the case of a die, suppose 2 comes, 2 is the outcome, right? So we will write down 2 over 2. So x is the outcome. And then you have to square the outcome. See, x square, this is called the multiplication, probability of x. What is the probability of x that 2 will come? If I say 1 over 6, then you have to multiply the square of outcome with the probability. Right? Individually, you have to do this. Then we will add. And then we will minus mu square. What is mu? We have learned in the first lesson, but I will explain it to you again. Mu is the mean, how to calculate the mean. Whatever is the mean, you have to square it and then you have to subtract from this part. It's called the variance. When we will take the square root of the variance, it is called the standard deviation. Right? So we will start the problem, but first I will show you how to calculate the mean as well, and these are the steps in order to calculate the variance and standard deviation of a probability distribution. Keep in mind, here we are going to learn probability distribution, right? Standard deviations of and variance of probability distribution. First, you have to find out the mean, right? Why mean? Because here you have to subtract the square of the mean. That is why we have to find out the mean. Square each of the outcome, then multiply the square of each outcome by its corresponding probability. See, what is the outcome? You have to square, multiply by the corresponding probability, make a sum, subtract the square of the mean from step 4. This one, right? Square of the mean from step 4. Take the square root to find the standard deviation. So here is one example. How to calculate the mean? Suppose in the case of a coin, number of heads x, and the probability is, if I say 0 head will come, if you will toss 3 coins together, 3 coins, right? So maybe t means tail, all of them have tail, maybe 2 tail and 1 head. This is the probability. Maybe in one coin we have tail, head and tail, and then head, tail. Similarly, 2 heads. Maybe 2 heads will come and 1 tail, right? Maybe 1 head, tail. So these are the probabilities. And maybe 3 heads will come. So the probability that the three tails will come is 1 over 8. Why 8? Because total number of possibilities are 8. These are the sample space. And numerator, you have to write down the outcome. So outcome is 1. Similarly, one head will come. There are three possibilities that only one head will come. There are three possibilities that two head will come. And one possibility that three of them have head. So 1 over 8. So I told you how to calculate the mean. You have to write down the outcome. This is the outcome and then multiply by its probability. This is the outcome, multiply by its probability and so on. So it is the outcome of the first is 0. So it will be 0, which is equal to, if we add the rest of the 3, it is equal to 12 over 8. 1.5 is the theoretical mean. Because in the case of a coin, we do not have, coin does not have 1.5. So this is the theoretical mean. One more example of mean in the case of a die. There are 6 possibilities. These are the probabilities. You have to write down the outcome, multiply by probability, outcome, multiply by probability and so on. When you will add the average or the mean is 3.5. Again, it is the theoretical mean, because die does not have 3.5, right? So we will continue this mean in order to calculate the variance and standard deviations. So first step is to calculate the mean. We did it. Second step is square the outcome. So these are the outcomes. Maybe the 1 will come, 2 will come, 3 will come, 4. So square it. So I did. See, 2, 4, 9, 16. These are the square of the outcome. Now you have to multiply the probability of these squares. So see, 1 and the probability is 1 by 6. Second outcome is 2. So square it, square, and the probability is 1 by 6. And this is the 9 and then probability is 1 by 6. Why I am doing this? Because I have showed you here. In this, x square of the outcome multiply by probability. So we are going to multiply with the probability. When you will simplify it, we will get 15.167. This is the step number 3 and 4 I did together. Now you have to subtract the square of the mean, and we have calculated mean here, 3.5. Square it, it will be equal to 12.25. Right, so subtract from this, we will get 2.917. This is the variance, right? And then take the square root of this variance, which is the standard deviation. So we have used these 6 steps in order to calculate the variance and standard deviations of the probability distribution. But same thing we can do with the help of this table. Suppose these are the outcomes of a die, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Each has the same probability, 1 by 6, 1 by 6. Third column is multiply x and this probability, this one, like this. Right, 2 multiply by this, 3 multiply by this. So we will get the third column. And when you add the third column, it will show you the mean. Whatever we have calculated in the previous slide, so this is the mean. Now, in order to calculate the variance and standard deviation, you have to square this outcome. This is the square and multiply with this. Right, in third column, we just multiply this, 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 this. Now in fourth column, we are multiplying the square of this x and then multiply with this. Square of 4 and then multiply 1 by 6. Square of 5, which is equal to 25, then multiply with this. So we will get the third column. Make the total of the third column, which is equal to 15.167. Same thing, 15.167 here. And then we have to subtract a square of the mean. We will get sigma square, which is the variance. Take the square root, we will get the sigma or standard deviation. Right, so in this lesson, you have learned how to calculate the mean, variance and standard deviations of a probability distribution. If still you have any questions, you can write down in comment section. And thanks for watching.